Top Minnesota races that we're watching today is a contest for U.S. Senate. Democrat Al Franken is being challenged by Republican Mike McFadden. That outcome could play into the national scene. Joining me with more now is Catherine Pearson, a political science professor at the U of M. Catherine, thanks for being here this morning.
My pleasure.
So let's talk a little bit about the McFadden and Franken race. Al Franken has led most of the polls we've seen, although we have seen that sort of narrow up here in the last couple of weeks.
Right, and Senator Franken has the advantage of having served in the Senate for 5.5 years, building up a record to campaign on. He's well known to voters, and so McFadden has had more of a challenge of not just getting his name out, but also really introducing himself to voters and making the case that he would be different than Senator Franken.
So nationally, I don't see this particular race talked about as far as the balance of power, big picture. Is it your presumption that the pundits at the national level think that Al Franken has this locked up?
Right. So the national analyses have tagged this as a likely Democratic seat. Not a safe Democratic seat, mm-hmm. but a likely Democratic seat. And Republicans need 6 seats nationwide to take majority party control of the U.S. Senate. And they're definitely poised to do that. There are many, many competitive races, many that could go either way. And so we won't know until late tonight or actually until a couple months from now, depending on the outcome of potential runoff elections in competitive seats in Louisiana and Georgia.
The last debate, I don't know what your impression was, the radio debate mm-hmm. on NPR, mm-hmm. the tone that McFadden and Franken had, I felt like it was very gentlemanly for the most part. Do you think that was a strategical move by Mike McFadden to sort of strike that tone instead of being aggressor?
It certainly could have been, and it was a marked contrast from a previous
yes.
debate. But it was great for voters to really hear an exchange of how they differ. We heard familiar themes, also, you know, McFadden's big talking point of connecting Senator Franken to President Obama.
Sure, which is kind of everyone's.
Right, who's. Approval ratings are low in Minnesota and nationwide, and then Senator Franken talking about his accomplishments in the Senate. So mm-hmm. we really saw their two themes play out in that debate again, but also, yes, a more collegial tone.
Well, we appreciate your time so far. We'll talk again in a little bit in the
Great.
Next half hour. We have much to discuss this morning. Producer would be mad, though, if we didn't get to some other news. Now, coming up at 6:30, Catherine will be back again. We'll be looking at some of the big races to watch locally, including the contest for governor and the U.S. House. Keep it right here on 5 Eyewitness News for your complete election coverage. We'll be watching as the results trickle in, bring you those throughout the evening, and then, of course, tomorrow morning.
Happening today.